Well, the day wouldn't be complete without a little Britney Spears baby mama drama update. Britney Spears has regained temporary visitation rights with her two kids. Her attorney says that a judge is once again allowing Spears to visit with her boys under court supervision. She was reportedly seen around L.A. on Saturday with the kids and the presumed guardian. On Wednesday, a judge said that Spears couldn't visit with her kids unless a parenting coach was present. Somebody caught up with her yesterday and asked her, "How's your Malibu house in the fire?" And she's like, "I don't know."
Which house was that again?
I know.
Yeah,
well,
right.
Got a lot of them, I guess.
Well, we got a couple that seems to be on the cover of every celebrity magazine with questions like, are they divorcing? Are they adopting? Is she pregnant again? Who could we be talking about?
Well, we're talking about, and the person we always love to talk to about these kinds of things, Tony Potts from Access Hollywood. Your latest expose focuses on Brad and Angelina. So tell us something that we do not know about these two.
Well, I can tell you something real quick about Britney Spears you don't know. The house that she's talking about, she does not own. She's renting it. So she's fine. She doesn't care. She's renting the darn house. So.
Oh, well, finally some good news for Britney Spears.
Let me ask you, what high school did Brad Pitt go to? Do you know?
I can tell you what college he went to because he went to my college. I went to the University of Missouri, and he was also in the journalism program.
Wow.
And let's just say my professors used to talk about him many years later.
Really? He went to Kickapoo High School. That's where he went to high school. So there's something you didn't know already, and we've only been talking 20 seconds. How great is that? Imagine a whole hour of these two and the things you're going to learn. The great thing, though, seriously, for a minute, is that I'm trying to watch the fires as we're going here as well. I got them on monitor because my house is also surrounded by fire, so I'm kind of keeping an eye on that. One of the things I want to tell you is that the great thing about our hour show about a celebrity, or two celebrities in this case, is the fact that we have, by virtue of Access Hollywood, which is what I work for that show, obviously, and I've been a part of for years. Access Hollywood produces this show. We've been with Brad and Angelina since day one in Hollywood. So you'll see kind of how they, and you'll hear them in their own words, as opposed to most of these hour shows that have talking heads, talking about these celebrities and then met them. Well, we've been with them. I've been with them personally, both of those folks, Brad and Angelina. So you'll see them, like from Angie's first role in a movie, to Brad leaving Kickapoo High School. Actually, we go back to Kickapoo High School and talk to some of his teachers and stuff. Mm-hmm. So you see how they morphed from that, this Midwestern boy, this Hollywood bad girl, into this now, this kind of power couple, not only in Hollywood, but now somewhat on a global level.
So are these two the real deal? I mean, is this a real relationship? A lot of people speculate in the magazines that it's really more an arrangement of two people who want to have a lot of kids.
What isn't an arrangement? I mean, a marriage is an arrangement of your values, your love, and how you live. No, I think they love each other. I think they've captured each other's imagination, their hearts. I think Brad is probably the most stable man she's had in her life ever. He's a Midwestern kid, as you well know, with good Midwestern values that somehow he's kept into his adulthood here in Hollywood, of all places. And Angie's come from her self-destructive past. You'll see an interview I sat down with her a number of years ago where she talks about self-mutilation and knives and what have you. And she's come from that kind of negative energy and somehow turned that around and morphed into this worldly woman who is now helping others as an ambassador to the UN. And I think the colliding of those two forces, his stability and her worldly views, have really had a good effect on both of them. And now they have kids, and he just told us the other day, and you'll see this in the show, that they probably want more kids as well, and probably number five will be on the way shortly.
So do you get the sense that they're just tired of all this publicity? I mean, obviously they've welcomed you into their lives, but at some point you have to draw the line. It's driving them a little bit crazy as well.
Yeah, but the great thing about them is that they understand it. So they still try to conduct their lives as best they can. But,
Tony,
Brad said to us, there's a helicopter outside of my house every day.
Thank you, Tony. The show airs tonight on My 58. We'll see you again tomorrow.